Hi, AT from CNC at home. A while back we went through how to make a clock face using LightBurn. It's a relatively easy process of basically taking a circle. So I'll just take the circle tool, press the shift key so it makes a circle. And then I have a nice circle, and if I had specific sizing I could give it to at that point I could do that. But that's the basic shape of our clock. It's round, at least for our numbers and that sort of stuff. And what you do then is you just put some text on here. So we'll start at the 12 o'clock position with the number 12. And we'll just take that, get it positioned exactly where we want it, move it up a little bit higher. We'll shift select our big circle and make sure that that's centered in there. All right. Now we just select what we want. We select what we want to rotate it about, which is our big circle. And then we come over here and use our circular array. I'll click on that. Oh, it looks like I already have my parameters set up. So that's good. So we're going to start at 0, which is the top. We're going to go around 360 degrees and make 12 of these. What we can do is when we rotate these, we can take the rotate object and turn that on, which is kind of neat, so then it rotates everything around as it goes. I want all my numbers to be straight up and down, so we'll just leave them like that. Then what I have to do is I have to go through and edit each one of these to make it the correct number. Okay, that's not a big deal. It doesn't take too long to do. And then once I have it, then I'm done. What I had happen today was a viewer mentioned or did a comment wanting to know that if on the clock face, was there a way to use the variable option or variables option within LightBurn to do that? Turns out there is. Doing it this manual way or the brute force way didn't take too long. I've got my basics for the clock. I can, you know, change the font, make them bigger, smaller, do all that, add images, center hole, all that sort of stuff. What I want to do is talk about the variable text options within LightBurn and show you two different ways that we can do this same project. So let's just start a new project. Again, let's go to a tool layer. We'll make a circle. And the circle, if I hold down the shift key, it does a perfect circle. If I don't hold the shift key, I get an ellipse or an oval. So we'll hold that down. We'll make some random sized, let's make that 300 just so it's a nice even number. All right, so that's going to be the size of our clock. And I will start out by putting some text on here. But this time, instead of putting the number 12, I'm going to put the letters DD. And you can say, well, why did you do DD? That doesn't make any sense. It will. It will. So we'll just pretend that's a number for now. And we'll get that centered up the same way. We'll just collect that. There we go. What we want to do is change this from being a normal text. We want to change this to be a serial number. And then we also want to come over and do our variable text tab, which we don't have. By default, that's not on. So I'm going to go over to Windows and get that turned on. It's the very last one here, variable text. What variable text will allow me to do is set that to 0, is tell it where I want it to start. And I want it to start at 12. We don't need that either. And if I click the test option, there we can see that that's a 12. So that's pretty cool. If I do the preview option, we just get a big 12 because that's the only thing that's going to burn. So now what I can do is I can take this and I can do the same rotate or the same circular array. Have my DDDs all the way around. Oops. To say that I want that. There we go. Now one thing that you saw me change maybe earlier was this offset. My very first one I want to be at 0. This next one I want to be at 1. And this one at 2. And what that'll do is it'll increment the value as it goes around based off of the parameters that I have set over here. So if we look at this now, It's doing that, but that's not what we want. We don't want 12, 13, 14. We want 12, 1, 2, 3. So that's kind of an oddity. How do we deal with that? Well, one easy way to do that, we'll just back up here a little quick, is instead of rotating this all the way around, is we'll just rotate it 30 degrees. And we'll just do one copy there. And then we'll get rid of the first one. Oops, we don't want to get rid of all that. There we go. Just get rid of that. And then here we'll make our offset 0. Now that we have that, we'll rotate that one around all the way. So instead of 30 degrees, we'll go 360, and we'll have 12 of those. Boom. Now when we start, we want to start at 1 because this is our first one at our 1 o'clock position. And we do our preview. Everything's exactly like we want it. So pretty straightforward. That's kind of a neat way to do that. I don't know if it's really any faster if you're doing clocks all the time. It might be. But why wouldn't you just have a clock tempo that started you out? Anyway, I thought it was an interesting idea that the viewer had, and so I had to dig into it. There is another method that gives us a little bit more flexibility doing a similar kind of thing. Let's go ahead and just start a new clock here. We'll create that, put it on our tool layer 1. We'll make it the same size just for consistency. And then this time, what we'll do is instead of, oh, hey, don't do that. There we go. So instead of doing DD, and that's for digits, 2 digits. If I only had 1 digit there, our 10 would have been a 0, 11 would have been a 1. That's no good. What we want to do here is we're going to use, instead of using the serial number, we're going to use an external file called a CSV, and that's a comma separated value file. And it's a 0 based, so I'm going to tell it I want the first column, which is column 0. And that's what I'm doing there. So I have my column 0. I'll put that up here. I'll shift select our circle, make sure it's centered. And here's what I need to do. I always forget this step. I'll eventually remember. As I change this to merge CSV, then I can go and I can browse and I can open up my file. The file itself looks like this. This is my 12-hour clock, so it starts at 12, then goes to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way up to 11. So if we do our preview now, that's a 12. I just rotate this around like I've done before, so I select the circle, so I use the center for rotation. Everything else is set. Click OK, and now when I look at the test, it's exactly what we want to see. The nice thing about this is, what if I wanted to switch these to Roman numerals? This template doesn't have to change. All I have to change is to a different file. Let me show you that file. Here's the Roman numeral file. Again, it starts at 12, so XII, then 1, 2, 3, 4. And you'll notice that for the 4 o'clock position, I did 4 I's. And with clocks, that's typical. If you go look at an old clock anywhere that uses Roman numerals, the 4-hour mark will be 4 I's instead of an IV. Not quite sure why they did that. It's valid within Roman numerals. It's an older standard, more of an original standard, but that's how it's done. So with this file, if we open that up, if we do our preview, now we have a Roman numeral clock. And if we're going to have a Roman numeral clock, we probably should change the font too. So let me just select everything and let's switch to, here we go, Times New Roman. That'll look much better for Roman numerals. Let's go back to our variable text and do our test. Simple. So easily switching back and forth, I can go back to our 12-hour clock. So that's an advantage to doing it this way. Another idea that I had was, well, what if I want to have a 24-hour clock? Well, I have a file for that. I just switch over to 24-hour clock, And it starts at 0 and goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I could also have that start in the 12th position on that file. And so it actually starts then at 12, then 13, 14, 15, all the way up to 23. If we open that file, you can see what I'm talking about. Here we can see our 24-hour clock. Starts at 0, goes up to 12, but keeps on going up to 23. So we have two sections of 12 numbers, essentially. What that allows us to do then is back in our variable text, we can tell it where to start. So when I start at the 12th value, which really is the 13th because it's 0 base, so the very first one is 0, then 1, 2, 3. It looks like this. It starts with 12 and goes forward from there. So let me just put this back to 0. This does our 0, 1, 2, 3. And if I wanted to now, I could create a second ring of values. So I'm just going to do a copy and a paste of that value and make it go up just a little bit. I'll have it a little bit closer. Okay. And then make its offset instead of 0, because a 0 offset is going to make it the same value. I'm going to get an offset of 12. So now that actually gets the 13th value from our list. And if we look at our list, the 13th value, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, the 13th value is 12. So that's exactly what it's doing here, is bringing that in. Now I can take that value, do a shift select of our circle, do our circular array, use the same parameters that we already had. Now this should have an offset of 13, this should have an offset of 14, etc. If I do a test, there we go. We have an inner circle now with our second half of the day, 1200 through the end of the day. So that's kind of a neat feature, something different way to do it, I guess. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. It really helps us out. I like learning new features or doing new adaptations of existing features within LightBurn. I hope you enjoyed watching this. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.